So your today's topic is we'll do some problems regarding this method of lighting. So before going to the actual problems, let us again let me speak about what are the three methods of lighting which was actually discussed yesterday. These are the three methods. I think you can you see the screen, all of you?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, the methods that are employed for this particular lighting calculations are, there are totally three methods are there, okay. So what are the three methods? The three methods are lights per square meter method, then the lumen or light flux method, and point to point or inverse square law method. Out of these three methods, the second method is very, very important, okay. And basically most of the problems comes from the second method only. So in brief, let me explain you. Because I think you might have missed the class. The first one is watts per square meter method. That means whenever you are going to the market, you are buying the bulb, and you are asking him, give me a 7-watt CFL bulb, give me a 10-watt incandescent bulb, okay, give me a 100-watt bulb. So that is the specification that you are asking to the electrical shop or to the shopkeeper. Okay, based on that particular specification of what you are actually buying the bulb. Now, how much watts of bulb, 100 watt of bulb is required? For example, you are buying a 100 watt bulb. You should have a certain idea that 100 watt of bulb is going to give lighting to how much square meter area, how much meter square area of the room. Okay, so this is a watt per square meter method is you can say it is a kind of rough calculation, and you are checking actually, or hit and trial method you can say. Yeah, so here what you are doing is you are making an allowance of watt per square meter of area, how much has to be illuminated. Illuminated means how much area you have to give the lighting to that particular room. Suppose the size of the room is 40 meter square. What? How much? The size of the room is 40 meter square. For 40 meter square, how much watt bulb is required? So that by hit and trial method, you are using it such that the overall consumption of electrical energy should be minimum. Okay. So here we don't have any kind of what you can say calculations required that you are doing it with the help of a pen and paper. But second one is what much more important, that is lumen and light flux method. Here we have a particular formula. Okay, and if you want in detail about this particular method, if you want, you can go through the particular video which I have shared yesterday, clear, about this lumen and light flux method. But presently, there is a particular formula for this particular lumen and light flux method. So, here, what is actually the particular formula here? The formula is total lumens, clear? So let me show you this. The formula is this. Please wait. Can you see this?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. The formula is lumens received on working plane. You can hear, you can see. This I'm talking about. Lumens received on working plane. So what is the formula here? Number of lamps into wattage of each lamp. On each lamp you have this wattage, how much watt bulb it is, it is written. How many number of lamps you are using, clear? So here in this lumen method, we are actually calculating how much lumens you want to receive on that particular working plane. Suppose you are sitting in a room, so that is your working area. In that working area, how much light is required, that you have to calculate. So the formula is number of lamps into wattage in each lamp, this you have to remember. Efficiency of each lamp. that is in terms of lumens per watt into coefficient of utilization. Please, you see, this is very important. Coefficient of utilization, you are multiplying. Depreciation factor you are going to use in that particular problem only, where around the bulb, if you are not maintaining the cleanness. Are you understanding? See, after the usage, suppose it is a new bulb, you won't find any dust around the bulb or around the fixtures. Okay. So suppose it is a new house, new room, totally you have whitewashed it. Clear? Then if you are putting a new bulb, their depreciation factor will not come into picture. But after 1 year, 2 years, around the bulb, if more dust is there, then this depreciation factor will come into picture. Please remember. So depreciation factor will come into picture when there is a dust around the bulb. Okay. Or else you have to multiply only coefficient of utilization. Remember, coefficient of utilization. Now, before that, what is the coefficient of utilization also? You have to know. Remember, coefficient of utilization is, it is very simple. Suppose, yesterday I was giving you a simple example. Coefficient of utilization or utilization factor means what? For example, let me give a small example, which I have said it yesterday also, that, for example, if I am giving you 100 rupees, how much? I am giving you 100 rupees to utilize that amount. So, you went to the market and out of 100 rupees, you have done expenditure of 30 rupees. How much expenditure you have done? 30 rupees for buying a particular product. Out of 100 rupees, 30 rupees you have utilized. So, now you say me, what is the utilization factor? Very simple. What is the utilization factor here? 30 by 100. 30 rupees you have utilized or not? Out of 100 rupees. So 30 by 100 is the utilization factor. Similarly, when you are lighting the bulb in a room, how much light is actually coming to you? Now you switch on the light in your room and you sit at one place. Okay, out of that 100 lumens, see that on the light it will be written 100 lumen, 200 lumen, 300 lumen, 1000 lumen. Out of that 500, suppose for example, in your room you have a bulb of 1000 lumen. Out of 1000 lumen, how much light is actually reaching to you where you are sitting? Suppose 500 lumen is only reaching to you. So your utilization factor is 500 by 1000. So out of 1000 lumen, which is coming at the intensity of light, you are only utilizing 500 lumen only. The rest 500 is wastage. Okay. So that is called utilization factor. Did you understand? Rajanan.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, you have understood the utilization factor?
So yes, sir.
Based on this formula, let us do a problem. Then you will ask, sir, what about the third method? Remember, the third method, that is point to point or inverse square law method, this particular method is only used where the illumination is due to one or more sources of light. That means if the number of lights in your room are more than one, if number of lamps or lights are more than one, then this particular method you are going to use in order to find out the what actually we are finding by this particular three methods. We are actually finding out how much is the lighting calculation, how much light you require, how much lumens you require, how much illumination you require in your room. That you are going to calculate by these three methods. So the last two method is basically the second method is you are using it most commonly for solving the problems. That is lumen and light flux method. The first one is your hit and trial method. And the third method is point to point or inverse square law method. This is required only when number of bulbs are more in a particular room. Okay. And this method is not more used practically because it is little bit complicated and its applications are also little bit complicated in nature. So only this particular method, inverse square law method and point-to-point method, is only used in special problems such as floodlights and yard lighting, street lights in the national highway. In those kind of special problems, only you are using this inverse square law method. Okay, so basing on this, so let us do a problem. Can you see the problem, all of you? And these problems are very important. Please answer somebody. Can you see the problem?
Yes,
So what is the problem there? The problem is a small assembly shop. This is somewhat related to your mechanical related. So a small assembly shop is there. Now, what is the length of the assembly shop? 16 meter long, and the width is 10 meter wide. Okay, and 3 meter up. What do you understand by 3 meter up? You can say it is the height. Clear? Up to the to a level of how much? 200 lakhs. Now, this is a particular assembly shop where the dimensions are given as a 16 meter length and 20 meter width, and up to the truss. Truss means, all of you know, we are talking about the joints. Clear? The pillar joints, you can say. That is the height. Clear? Up to that, you have to, it is to be illuminated. That means up to that particular height, that particular assembly shop, it should be illuminated. Illuminated means lighting should be provided to this particular area. Okay, and that lighting actually, it is, what is the, how much it is given? 200 lux. Okay, then what is actually lux? Lux means it is the unit. Lux is what? It is the unit of luminous intensity. And lumen is, lumen means what? Lumen is the intensity of luminous flux. And the relation between lux and lumen is one, please see here, one lux is equal to this, you have to remember, one lux is equal to, let us do one thing. So 1 lux is equal to 1 lumen per meter square. Okay, so this is a particular formula which you should remember. Clear? So this is the relation. 1 lux is equal to 1 lumen per meter square. Okay, please wait. Yeah, 1 lux is equal to 1 lumen per meter square. So this is the relation. So what is lux? Lux is the SI unit for luminous intensity, and lumen is the SI unit for luminous flux. Clear? So this is totally different. Remember, lux means how much light is actually falling on the wall, how much light is falling on the ground. But lumen is totally different. How much intensity of light is coming from that light? When you see a light, how much brightness it is? That is called lumen. Please try to understand. So this is the problem. So the utilization factor is given to you. What is the utilization factor? The utilization factor is here. As you can see, the utilization factor is 0.74, and the maintenance factor is 0.8. That is given to you. These two things. Now, what you have to calculate? You have to calculate the number of lamps required. How much? What are the number of lamps that are required to illuminate the whole area? If the lumen output of the lamp selected is how much? What is the lumen output? If the lumen output is 3000 lumens, then how many lamps are required inside that particular assembly shop? That you have to calculate. So, let us solve this particular problem. Clear? So this particular problem, let me try to solve it by typing it. So the problem is, so the given data, all of you please look. Can anyone help me? What is the working area here? Make it fast. What is the working area? The working area is 16 into 10. Okay, so that is 16 meter. The area. Area is what? Length into breadth, length into width. The length is given as 16 meter and width is 10 meter. So how much it is? 160 meter square. Clear? So here the working area is how much it is given? So working area is your 16 into 10, that is 160 meter square. All of you are there?
Yes,
Yeah, please answer. So the working area is how much? This much is the working area. Clear? Then, what more else is given to you in the question? In the question, how much is the required illumination? Can you say? Are the required illumination kete?
200.
Yes. Yeah, very good. The required illumination is, so let me write here, required illumination is how much? 200 what? 200 lux. Clear? So what is the total lumens required? How much lumen is required? So the total lumen required. So required illumination is 200 and working area is how much? Working area is 160 meter square. Now, basically, working area, it is designated by capital A, and required illumination is actually designated by, this you remember, required illumination is designated by how much? By capital E. Okay, so this is. So, what next one is, how much total lumens required? Total lumens required is how much? The formula is, remember, E into A. Okay, this much of lumens of bulb is required. Lumens of bulb is required. So E is how much multiplied by this? A is how much? 160. Clear? So 200 into 160.
32,000.
32,000. 32,000 कौन लुमेंस? Now, now you remember, lux और lumens में difference अच्छी है ना? Is this clear? So
Yes,
1 lumen per meter square. So this is what? How many lumens you got? 32,000 lumens you got. Okay. Now the question is, you have to calculate the number of lamps required to illuminate the whole area. Clear? So the total lumen to be given out by the lamps, that you have to find it out. Total lumens to be given out by the lamp. Clear? So that let us find it out. Next is what you have to find is the total lumens to be given out by the lamp. Okay, is the formula is the total lumens required on working area divided by utilization. Let me put a bracket. Please remember, in the denominator, it is utilization factor into maintenance factor. This is the problem. Is this clear? Total lumens that is to be given out of the lamp is equal to how much? That how can you calculate total lumens required on the working area? That is already I have calculated how much it is required, 32,000. Utilization factor is already given to you, how much? 0.74. And maintenance factor is already given to you, that is 0.8. If you want, you can mention out here. So based on this particular thing, so how can you calculate? This is equal to total lumens to be given by the lamp. That you can calculate it by this again. and just putting it copy paste, this multiplied by, so how much it is? 32,000. What is the utilization factor? 0.74 into, what is the maintenance factor? Please see the question, 0.8. Okay, so let us calculate here. So 0.74 into 0.8, you got 0.592. 32,000 divided by 0.592. It is 54,054. Okay, 54,054. The decimal let us leave. 54,054, because it is a pure number. 54,054 lumens. But if possible, you can take 54,000 also. There is no issue in the examination. Is this clear? Because it should be a totally number. Got it? Not a decimal. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay. The next one is actually what you have to find. That you now you have found out what is the total lumens to be given out of the lamp that you have found it out. But actually, that is not the thing which you have to find it out. You have to find out actually the number of lamps that are required in that particular room. Okay. So this number of lamps that are required in that particular room, that easily you can easily find it out in the next. The next, let us see. This is what you have calculated. Just I'm taking it to the front. Next slide. Okay, so this is the total number of lumens to be given out of the lamp. You got it as 54,054. But the actual question that you have to calculate here is, what is the number of lamps that are required to illuminate the whole area? This is the most important thing which you have to calculate. Yeah. So that you can get it, because already you got it, how much lumens is to be given out by the lamp. 54,054 is the total lumens that is given from the lamp. Or lamps, number of lamps, we are going to find it out here. So let us find out here. Okay, so the lamps required, where? In the, as given in the question, number of lamps required in the working area. We see here, number of lamps required to illuminate the whole area. I am writing working area. Okay, you can write working area, same. So how much, what the formula is simple as given here. So total lumens, total lumens given out by lamps divided by lumen output of each lamp. Okay. What is the total lumen given out by lamps? Yes. 54,054. Now, what is the lumen output of each lamp? You have calculated, na? Lumen output is how much? Sorry, it is lumen output is how much of each lamp? Given here in the question, you see lumen output of each lamp is how much? 3,000 lumens divided by 3,000. Okay. So, if I get the answer, 54,054 divided by 3,000. Get the answer. 18 point. You are calculating number of lamps, na? It should be number. So, ketra lamp darka?
18.
Got it in 18? 18 point you got decimal, so 18 lamps. So this much lamps are required to illuminate that particular room. Easy?
Yes,
In this way, you have to solve that particular problem. Got it? So again, this is a homework for you. I'll post it in the teachment. Try this particular thing. Okay, this problem, you try it, or else I'll send the answer for this also. Don't worry. You try and get me the answer in the evening. So you try this problem. So what is the question here? A minimum illumination of 80 lumens per meter square is required in a factory shed. How much illumination is required? 80 lumens per meter square. Okay, in a factory shed. What is the area of the factory shed? 100 into 100 meter into 10 meter. Calculate the number, location, and the wattages of the units to be used. How much number of lamps are required? Location also, and as well how much watts is watts are required. So what you have to assume, the factor is given, how much? 0.8. Then the coefficient of utilization is also given, 0.4, and efficiency of the lamp is given as 40 lumens per watt. Any idea how to solve? It is a similar way. Okay, in the previous problem, have you noted it down? If you have not noted, the link of this particular recorded class I will share with you. Okay, you can make it as a reference and try to solve this problem. Okay, see, can you say what is the area here? Make it fast. Area is how much?
1,000 meter square.
1000, yeah, 1000 meter square. How much illumination is required, can you say? How much illumination is required?
80
80. Very good. 80 lumens per
meter
meter
square.
square. And remember, here in the previous problem, you have calculated lumens required. You have calculated here. Yes or no?
Yes,
Because
sir.
lux, it was illumination was given in lux. But here, no need of this calculation and no need of multiplying E into A. Because already it is given directly, 80 lumens per meter square. I told you na, this 1 lux is 1 lumen per meter square. So that particular formula, it is no need to use here, because already the unit is there. You see, 80 lumens per meter square, already it is being multiplied. Okay, so what is the total lumens required here? How much is the lumens required? 80 into 1000. Okay, utilization factor is given 0.4. Depreciation factor is given 0.8 here. So you have to find out here by using that particular formulas which you have used in the formula. Try this, or else I'll share this particular solution of this in the teachment. Okay, try and share this solution of this. Is this clear? Or else we'll look it in the next class.
Yes, sir.